drummer, guess song, drummer, drummer, guess song, 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 drummer, guess song, drummer, drummer, guess song. The Drummer Show with me, Josh. This is episode 39. Coming up tonight on the episode 39. I went on the Southern League football show. I met James Beardwell from DTFC, a non-league football team in Essex. Wimborne pantomime at the Allendale Centre. Poole versus Salisbury. Bournemouth at Borough. Parley ability counts all finished until 2022. Bournemouth under 21s versus West Bromwich Albion under 21s. Cinderella at the Mayflower Southampton. Beauty and the Beast at the Lighthouse in Poole. Party fixtures at Dorchester. Tony Lee signs an 18-month contract. He's at Poole Town FC until May 2023. Comedy with Josh. Extra special on New Year was aired yesterday, Sunday the 19th of December. And finally for this week, Watercress Line in Hampshire, Oldsford, Oldson, etc. Have got their steam light illuminations between now and the end of December. So, hello and welcome to the Drummer Show with me, Josh, from Poole Town FC, but also my third party group, Parley Ability Counts FC as well. But also welcome aboard, partly Bournemouth as well. But mainly, Poole and Parley is what I do the Drummer Show for. So here we are with my new Poole Town Black and Gold shirt as part of our sponsorship with Black Gold Developments Limited in Poole, which is good. Southern League on our arms as well, made by Kappa, MGM Sports in Barnstable. Go and check them out. They do fantastic clothing just like this. This is a 3XL, by the way, but it's a good fit, actually. And hopefully if I can turn around on the back. Josh, 24. Oh, yes. Oh, yes, guys and girls, yeah. So, obviously, the number 24 is obviously partly like a squad number, but also that represents... that I'm at Poole Town as drummer. Should be up to May 2024. However, things might be changing, but we don't know yet. I hope not, because I really am enjoying it at Poole. I don't know if anyone's actually waiting to become Poole's drummer and stuff like that. It depends if we ever make the Conference South this season, especially when Tony Lee is... Well, he's obviously signed an 18-month contract, committing him at Poole Town until May 2023. So really, I want to try and work alongside that as well. That if Tony is staying at Poole, I want to stay at Poole. But Poole must give something back in return, which I know they will eventually and stuff. And of course, new ground plans and drawings are being considered and sorted out as we speak. Don't know where it's going to be. Exciting news as well, coming in the last week or so. But yes, I think I would love to stay at Poole because I think we have the team, we have got the board of directors and the chairman to take our club forward and get as high as possible in the divisions and earn some cash. Yeah, come on. Yes, so yes, very, very excited. But I mustn't get my hopes too high up. No. So, Struth, yeah, another cough attack, yeah. So anyway, tonight, about 45 minutes ago, I appeared on the Southern League football show. Basically, it's called the DNK Repossess Non-League Show, which is with David Square and Keith McManon. Keith is actually at Whitstable Town in Kent, just down the road from Herne Bay and Canterbury. And I'll tell you something in a minute about Whitstable and DTFC. Something coming up shortly, actually. And it's good news, in fact, as well. The show was good tonight. We spoke about Poole Town and obviously James's team, DTFC. It was very good because, you know, it's... I think what people have got to realise is, like, you know, I don't know why, but I am proud of it now. And I look back at it and it's good history, actually. But I've brought non-league football to another level. So has James. We have both raised awareness for non-league football clubs, just like Poole Town FC and DTFC in Essex. Because this should not be the Premier League dominating the tellies and playing football and earning loads of cash into billions of pounds deals and everything like that. It's just not right that so many clubs earn so much and non-league have to pay for players, and the lower the division that team is, the harder it is for cash. So that's why I'm so desperate for Poole to be as high up as possible. I'd say National League South at the moment is probably where we should be. However, the National League is somewhere I'd actually try and consider, along with Yeovil, Weymouth, Notts County, Stockport County, etc. Torquay as well. Basically all of those teams. Eastleigh in particular as well, actually. Yeah, Aldershot. Yeah, so many southern teams down that way, so that's good, yeah. But yes, that's Poole there. And also, I just found out tonight as well that DTFC were only formed in 2019. So DTFC haven't actually been around that long. I'd say 2 years at least. Coming on to 3 years. Not too long, actually. Good stuff. Very, very good for non-league football. I think Poole will hopefully improve during the second part of the season. We're not actually halfway through the season yet. We've got a game or two to try and catch up on. One of them's Hartley Whitney away, which I don't want to go to that one at all. Yuck. Yucky in North Hampshire, yeah. But yes, there we have it. Yeah. This depends what area, but... So yes, I think, you know, one day non-league football, well, I just hope that there'll be some type of funding. Even funding, let's say, from the smaller television companies like the BBC or ITV or Channel 4, Channel 5, Paramount Network, etc. Like all of those channels, I mean, surely they could come forward. Even Quest. I mean, at least one of those to come forward. Because all Sky, Amazon, and BT love to do is focus on the Premier League, Sky Sports in particular, and the Championship, yeah. BT, Premier League and National League. Oh, and the Champions League as well. So there's so many major competitions and tournaments and stuff like that as well to fit in and consider. But let's say this, you know, the Premier League gets over 200 games a season, at least. Because it's 38 games. Multiply that by 20, so that is 760 games per season in the Premier League, if that sounds right. I think so, yeah. The Championship also gets two or three games a weekend, sometimes just the one or two, against Sky Sports. League One, when there's an international break with the Premier League and Championship, Sky tend to look at a League One fixture. For example, Plymouth against Portsmouth, or Sunderland against, I don't know, Charlton Athletic, Ipswich against versus Cambridge. Kind of those games. MK Dons against, I don't know, Northampton, but I think they're in League Two. But, well, yeah, kind of something like that, you know. League Two, Swindon against Forest Green might be another one. Exeter against Bristol Rovers. Teams like that, you know. They might get a game on Sky if they're lucky. The National League, well, slightly better actually for that. BT Sport cover the National League. Not the North and South, would you believe? So, strange times, but I'm sure we can have an explanation soon, but yeah. But yes, I mean, what I am saying is that non-league football clubs, especially at Poole Town's level and DTFC's level, you barely get television coverage. You might get like a local broadcasting company like TBTV Sport with Tony Bradley, for example. They can't do it live due to a number of reasons and stuff. However, I think it should be considered. However, if they did that, then, you know, it's just, they won't get many fans on the gates. I think that's the message, you know. Non-league football will not be broadcasting on television. The only option or the only choice that you are going to watch it is by going to the game itself. What, in the freezing cold? Yeah, yeah, I know. It's just the way it is. But, yes. But, yes, non-league is fun. We need an increase in supporters for both sides, if we can. I've actually been invited as well by Keith on the show tonight to go and visit Whitstable Town in Kent. I've been invited to bring my drum with me. James will probably bring his as well, or something. Might have to share or something. We'll have to sort out a plan nearer the time. That's good. Also, I've been asked that hopefully I'll be able to make a DTFC game. Hopefully I'll be able to make one of those. Of course, DTFC is a lot different to Poole Town FC, where Poole Town, you're inside a stadium, fencing, borders and stuff like that. DTFC, it's mainly just an empty grass field, goalposts, the barriers that keeps supporters back and safe, like a safety barrier, like cordon type. Yeah, so it's a bit like, it's like a park, like a public park, but it's not. It's just, it's just where they play their games at the moment. DTFC, for their home games, they share Harlow Town in Essex as well, would you believe, as well. So actually, DTFC do have a stadium, but some away games, you're on a field with not really much around at all. Just two goalposts and some barriers, and that's it. So it's very different, and as I say, I'm very, very proud for James for following DTFC. Obviously, Witham Town didn't really work out for him, and, you know, people, even today, they still pick on James because of his Witham Town support, and that he left due to a number of reasons. And I wish people could stop picking on James, because, come on, I mean, he's got a disability. He's autistic. I mean, look at him. He is vulnerable. I mean, it's just, it's not nice, it isn't. So, if you know who you are, stop. Because James might get upset. But, yeah, but as I say, you know, DTFC, not a bad side, actually. But I will go and visit at some point. Just got to try and work around dates and see what I can do. And what James can do as well. But yes, I was just so delighted and thrilled to meet James tonight. He's been, well, a person that I've really looked up to, as David said on the show tonight. I didn't want to say inspirational, but an admirer instead, you know. But oh, it was just so wonderful. It was so good. But anyway, yes, I can't wait for some non-league games. DTFC, I'm coming at some point. Whitstable Town, hopefully soon. Otherwise, I don't want Keith to leave, and, you know, I won't get the chance to go. So hopefully he'll be there for a little while, because he does come and go. He was the manager of Phoenix, DJ Phoenix, something about Guernsey, but I'm not too sure on that one. But he's at Whitstable, and hopefully I will try and make one of their games again very, very soon. All right, moving on to yesterday. And yesterday, Wimborne Pantomime at the Allendale Centre, not the Tivoli. And this pantomime at Wimborne, that was very good. I really enjoyed it, full of laughter as well. The Tivoli, well, I'm sorry, but I don't really visit there ever again. I'm not really going to for a long time after an issue last year, which I'm not going to put on here. Bournemouth Pavilion and their pantomime, again, that's another one I don't go to at the moment, and that's been like that for 4 years now. So, two pantomimes missed in the area. But that's fine. I'm happy with the likes of Poole, Southampton, Weymouth, Salisbury, if it was good. But, well, we'll have to see about Salisbury on Wednesday and stuff. I'm actually going to Weymouth tomorrow, on the Tuesday, the 21st of December. So, getting the X12. Hopefully, it'll be a good bus. Or an XA as well, actually. So, yes. So that's all good. Yeah, so some more pantomimes for me coming up this week. I kind of decided now, but I've got to speak to Mum and Dad about it as well, that with Christmas and schedules and stuff, that on the Boxing Day, we probably won't make a game. The Monday, hopefully QPR against Bournemouth, if it goes ahead, depending on COVID cases. Otherwise, it'll be Dorch against Poole. Tuesday the 28th, I'm hoping to do Weymouth against Yeovil at Hewish Park. So Yeovil at home, of course. Wednesday the 29th, hopefully Swindon and Stevenage. That's a call of the 8 kickoffs. I have to get Dad to pick us up in Wiltshire. Thursday, Bournemouth Cardiff. Friday, I'm at Oakdean New Year's Eve party. 1st of January, Poole at home to Wimborne in the River Stour Derby. So it'll be a good game there as well. Don't know if James can make it, but probably not. He mentioned about April, so yeah, well, that's fine. Hopefully he'll remember, but I'll try and remind him, yeah. also the 2nd of January. I don't know yet. 3rd of January, Bournemouth, Peterborough. So it's quite a busy schedule coming up with pantos and football games. But I'm really looking forward to it. And yes, there we have it. And actually, as we speak, David Square has just messaged me. Happy Christmas and Happy New Year, Josh. Thanks for coming on our show. No worries. So anyway, moving on to Saturday's game I went to. Poole Town and Salisbury. That game ended 2-2. And, you know, I'm not really looking at it anyway. But I felt a bit sad about the Marvin Brooks chance aimed at him after Marvin played for us and then he went to Salisbury. I feel sad for Marvin, really. But obviously our Poole fans were like, you know, some of our Poole fans weren't going to bat down about it, or they weren't going to settle on it. So it wasn't the best, but I'm not interested in that. I was interested in the score of 2-2 and play my drum and follow the Dolphins, yeah. Yeah, but it's sad that lines can be crossed. It's a shame it is, but yeah, hopefully Marvin didn't take any notice, but bet Poole have got some complaints now, but it's just something that I don't want Poole to be so embarrassed about, but well, we haven't had any notifications on Poole Town website about that. Just having a look now, actually, in case I've missed it. Actually, the Poole Town website has changed completely. Oh my word, what have they done to it? It was red and white. It's actually now gone an orange and black, like a gold type. Oh my goodness. That's happened tonight as well. It wasn't like that earlier for me. So, yes, yeah, so as you say, you know, as I say, Poole is changing completely. And it's great that Poole are trying to move forward and start pushing on with sponsorship and moving on with our club and stuff. It's good because we're not slump. We're not dumb. Give us a chance. Come on. Come on, Dolphins. Come on, Poole Sanity. You can do this. Yes, come on. Yeah. Anyway, moving on. And lunchtime game on the telly. But also fans left at 3 in the morning from Bournemouth. 1 in Weymouth. 1 in the morning. And they went to Middlesbrough. And Bournemouth did not play very well. Middlesbrough beat the Cherries 1-0. Sky Sports, Sky TV is effing this, effing that. There was even a banner, 636 miles, half 12 kickoff. All fans deserve better. And credit to the Borough fans for doing that. Because obviously they suffered that with the Cardiff game away recently as well. So basically Sky don't care about fans, but either it's a true statement or it's not. But again, I can't really debate it, no. So we mess it up at Christmas. Bournemouth have. How disappointing. Hopefully Poole will beat Dorchester on the 27th. Really hope so as well. That would be really good. Yep, that would be a good game, I hope. Yeah. Yes. Parley have now all finished until 2022, so they won't be back at Westports until Friday the 4th of January. 4th of January? No, that can't be right. 7th of January, that's it. Yep, Friday the 7th of January. That's what I'm getting mixed up with now. I'm thinking of the Tuesday, that's why. Yeah, so Friday the 7th of January, Parley return to West Moors. Don't be late. Otherwise, one day, I'm going to lose it. Oh, dear. Don't want to see that. No. Anyway, last Thursday, Bournemouth Academy under-21s took on West Brom under-21s. That game finished 4-0 to Bournemouth, and that was my first ever time at the Vitality playing a drum, which was good. I'm hoping to do Southampton home game at the Vitality on Friday, the 11th of February, 7 o'clock kickoff. Also, I'm going to try and source out or negotiate that Parley might be able to entitled to a few tickets for that Premier League Cup game. I don't know about segregation. I mean, I would like a segregation in case of any issues. Like Saints have one corner of a stand and we'll have another, but I don't think there'll be a segregation, but yeah, but well, it'll be a bit difficult actually, because if it was that, then oh, I don't know. I think we'd have to go in the Saints end, because Rob the manager, Victoria, they both follow the Saints, they do. Also the Cherries fans, so that's going to be a bit difficult, but hopefully just a standard game would be okay, and hopefully everyone will be fair and nice to each other. But yes, 4-0 to the under-21s on the 16th of December, just gone. That was a good game, I really enjoyed that night as well. Also, two pantomimes that I went to recently. They are Cinderella at the Mayflower and Beauty and the Beast at the Lighthouse in Poole. And both of those were good pantomimes. No spoilers. Parley fixtures at Dorchester. Again, that went very well. Panthers did incredibly well. You know, I think this myself, but no one's really told me this, that the Panthers actually do better without me. And that's what I want anyway, because, you know, I just can't keep up with Parley's demand at the moment. I'm falling behind expectations, and I'm sorry. And, you know, being a manager is quite difficult, but I am going to get some help and support very soon. And I'm starting to, but starting to go back to square one again at the moment. But yeah, everything's good, positive. Just one or two things, just try and sort out. Yeah, Tony Lee, Poole's striker, one of my favourite players, and the fans really look up to him as well. He has signed yesterday evening an 18-month contract. He is at the club until May 2023. And because of that, that's actually kind of changed my mind of, you know, if Tony is going to be at Poole until the end of May 2023, I might as well stay as drummer until it should be 2024, but hopefully I'll be at Poole until 2024 with a drummer role. Just thinking about, you know, that at the moment, Poole very happy with me doing the drum for them. I don't really know if there's anyone waiting to take on this role. Poole's not really told me. So at the moment, still carrying on as normal and usual. Yeah, so I'm really pleased with that news. It's on the Echo, it's on Twitter, it's gone kind of viral around the Poole community. I think everyone is so delighted. It's, as Poole described, it's an early Christmas present. What, by 6 days? Yeah. But yes, we'll take it. And Tony Lee, he's taking us up. Come on. Bloody do this, come on. You can do this. Poole Town can do this. Come on, you Dolphins. Yes, come on. I absolutely mean it. Yeah, come on. Of course, the Watercress line at Oldham has the Steamlight Illuminations train going between 4 o'clock and 10 o'clock at night. That was really good. I went there on the Saturday night after the Poole game. That was really good. Really enjoyed that. I would highly recommend it. Definitely going back next year, though. Come on, yes. Love it. Love Oldton. I mean, the roads are so quiet. Reminds me of Reading and Basingstoke, really. But better than the M3. Very funny. Yeah, so love that part of Hampshire. That's so good. Of course, I love Ringwood and New Milton as well, and Fordham Bridge and stuff like that. But it's just such a warm welcome at the Watercress Line. And, well, it's better than Swanage Railway as well. By miles. 20-mile round trip between Oulton and Oldsford and back again. Tickets went very quickly, actually, as well. So I'm glad we did it. And finally, for tonight's episode of The Drummer's Show, Comedy with Josh, Xmas and New Year special. That was aired yesterday. There are two parts, as it was 57 minutes long, and that I needed a break in the middle as the computer was playing up. Bradley, the champion of variety, thinks that there is a virus bug going round. It's called a condemic computer demic. That's how Bradley described it. But yep, I think there is. Must be a computer type of thing, but I don't know. But it's oh dear, cough attacks, yeah. Seems to be working right now as we speak. That's also good as well. So some really good things. And 39 episodes. Drummers update between 1 and 30. The Drummer Show between 31 and 39. One more to come. 5 days till Christmas. Hopefully that last Drummer Show episode will be 40. And I think I'll have to stop there as well. As, you know, I just don't have the time anymore to do these episodes. I was going to go up to 50. I think Adam Moore really wanted that as well. But sorry, it's going to have to stop at 40, which is the final episode after this one. But yes, some good stuff here. And some good things coming up. And yeah, that's all I can say. Yeah. So, I wish everyone a happy Christmas and a happy New Year. Stay safe. Don't forget your face coverings in shops and wherever you go, indoors. See you for the episode 40 of The Drummer's Show, which will be aired probably around Christmas Day, Boxing Day, somewhere around there, if we're lucky. Thank you for watching. See everyone soon. Tonight, I leave you with an instrumental of Kelly Clarkson and her famous Christmas number one, Underneath the Christmas Tree. Good night, everyone, and thanks for watching. Good night.